Hey everybody, hey, I'm out here in the shop working on my BMW 335, an E90, 2008. This is going to pertain to a lot of different BMWs that have the folding mirrors. And as you can see, my mirror has folded outward like this. And you're going to probably find this on a lot of cars. And I got online to figure out, all right, how do I fix this? And you know, what switch needs to be replaced or whatever it is. And it turns out it's not a switch at all. There's actually a pin that gets stuck in the up position and it doesn't go back down. There's a spring behind it, and the lubrication apparently wears out, or it gets crusty, or you know, if you live in a state like I do where there's lots of salt, maybe live on dirt roads, you're gonna have this issue where the pin won't go back down, so the mirror cannot home back to where it's supposed to be and lock into place. So I got online and I found a whole bunch of threads on how to fix this, from cutting a wire to keep the motor from running. And then you basically have to go out and manually put it where you want it. I guess that would work. I myself would like to have the mirrors, you know, continue to work as they should. Other people have taken the mirrors off completely and gotten the drill out, have to drill the whole motor apart, the whole assembly, and then they free up the pin and the spring, and then they put it back together. Have to weld the thing back together. What a pain that is. So what I've found is you can do this without having to even take the mirror off the car. So let me show you what I've got here. So the first thing you're going to need to do is take this back cover off, and that comes off with some clips and a couple of minor broken. This fallen off a couple times in the car wash. You have to be real careful with these, but so you peel it off. There's some clips. These clips here go in and snap in. So anyways, you peel this piece off. So the whole problem is the mirror's trying to find its home point, which is right here. And what'll happen is it'll go right on past it, because there's a pin that's supposed to come down and lock it into place. So what after reviewing lots of videos of people tearing this whole mechanism apart, pulling the mirror off the car and drilling the pieces out and taking the whole motor apart, and what a mess. All they're really doing is lubricating that spot that has the spring and the pin. That spring and pin are right here, right in this area here. So all I did is I took a drill bit, I drilled a hole right in the top here, drilled it through till I hit the pin, and then I took a little screwdriver with a point on it, and I started hammering it down till I get that pin to move. And then I filled it with WD-40. Let me show you. So basically I took the drill and I found this spot right in here, just from watching other people's videos and seeing some pictures, knowing the pin was just in this area. And I drilled this hole down till I hit the hard spot there. I kind of moved a little bit. So about that far. Is that about a quarter inch or so? And the drill kind of dropped in. Once it did that, I figured, okay, I'm into the crevice where the spring is. So once the hole was drilled, I took a little pointy awl kind of thing and stuck it in there and moved around. I could feel that there was a hole in here. I could feel there was like a space. I figured that was behind the spring there. So I took my WD-40 and I just kind of lightly put it on there. You can see it sucking in. And I took my hammer. I have a brass hammer here. Just kept tapping on it, kept adding WD-40 and tapping, and then making sure that I could get this awl in here. And I was pushing it, and I had two different types of awls I was using, and just trying to get the oil down in there, and then moving this back and forth. Okay, so here's a better shot at the hole that I drilled. It's right here. And then if you take my little awl, you can, if you look closely, you're gonna see it bouncing as I move it up and down. You can feel the pin moving right here, moving up and down. So I know I've got it loose now. So that's really all there is to it, is to just get that hole in the right spot. And I might be off a little bit. It's right in this area though. And I can feel the pin going up and down. So now I have the mirror positioned back into this up against the car position. And let's see if it comes back to where it should.
And as you can see, it goes back and forth just like it should now. So what I'm going to end up doing is getting a little hot melt glue and just putting it over that hole there so no schmutz gets in there. And if I have this problem again, I'll just pull the hot melt glue off and be able to re-oil that as needed and hopefully fix this once and for all. Driver's side's still good, so you never know. It's probably going to go next. So, all right, guys. Well, I hope this helps you out. So thanks for watching.